Okay, I'm gonna do it. I guess I could call it a first video with my new setup for diamond painting. So I got this swing arm, got a light there, got a light, and I made this 2x4 setup. Had that glass just sitting around. Then made my own light pad. So these lights are just the ones that you put under the countertops, or the cupboards. So got that, the glass itself made. Then I made this a light pad box or whatever you want to call it. So there's two 2x4s and a piece of quarter inch plywood. I felted the whole thing, make it look good. So this is my first time with the swing arm setup. So I wanted to do, because I've had this swing arm for about a week now, but this is the first time I'm actually using it, because I had to wait for this guy. Came in 2 days ago, and I just got busy actually decorating the truck the other day, so for Christmas. Got Christmas lights on it. So this is 3/8, but this here is quarter inch. Everything I use is quarter inch, so I had to get this adapter. So I'm gonna do a bit of a diamond painting here. Okay, let me just set up. Sorry, just trying to get a nice angle going here. Maybe I go like that. First time I use this setup, so. So I want to try to get a good. How's this look? What I kind of want is to have like that, maybe. Oops, sorry. Okay, let's go to that. Some spots a little blurry, but not much. I'll try to figure it out. Right now, I just want to do a bit of a video for you guys. Alright, gonna work on K. So, these parts here, the white parts. Oh, great, I just moved it. Let's see here. Well, it's still okay. Like I said, this is my first video with using the swing arm setup. So, if you guys can suggest something I've done differently, or if you actually like it, let me know. Okay. So, I'm doing this on a bistro set. So, the reason why I got the new, or I guess, yeah, it is new. So I got the bigger diamond tray because I had to use multiplasers. So three, then I got four and five here, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12, 13, and 14 and 15. Also, one really good thing to have, which I didn't even think about till about a week ago, little bead funnels. Helps a lot. And instead of the wax that comes with the kits, I use this. The Aliens, I think I'm spelling it right, or sounding it right. The Instant Tacky, it's called. And, sorry about the arm. I got this roller. I believe it's Mod Podge roller. Just after each section, I just roll everything with it. Anyhow, now that you guys seen that, and this here, the tape, sorry, some stuff just fell. The tape I'm using is just regular painter's tape. Doesn't stick or nothing, so I'm using it. Well, I mean, doesn't it sticks just enough, I guess you could say. Hopefully you guys can see. Let's see, what does it look like there? Trying to get the whole thing in the picture if I can. Oh, sorry guys. There. Can you guys still see? It's hard to get. I'm thinking it might be because I'm trying to do such a big area. Maybe next video I'll have it kind of like that. So that way the zoom can actually be, maybe that's the thing. Maybe I'm just trying to zoom into too big of an area. Although you can still see a little bit of it. That's right. I know I'm moving it a bunch, sorry. It's really trying to make it. Like I said, this is the first time I use this thing. Okay, the whole thing's in the picture. Oh, is it the light here? It's affecting it. Is that any better? No, not really. What was that light? Okay, I think it's good, I think. I think I'll just go with this and then next one. Because it seems smaller area, seems like I can get better details, so that's what I'll do next time. Okay, just move this. Sorry. God, I feel like an amateur doing this. I guess I am somewhat new still at doing videos, so. So like I said, I was, last couple of days I was busy with the... I like to decorate the truck with Christmas lights. I have, the lights I have, two sets are... solar powered. The other set is two AA batteries that power it, that one. The two sets. I did a video of it. If you guys want to go take a look at that. Sorry, it has been a while since I've done a YouTube video, so. Alright, well, I'm trying to get back into it. Not sure how anyone else usually does theirs. But I like to section mine off and I just do color by color, top to bottom, left to right. Not sure if that's because I'm left-handed or why, that's the way I just started doing it and just been making them like this ever since I started. So if you guys have any suggestions of, you know, how it can make it look different way, or if you guys like it, let me know. But I think that's one thing I'm going to try is to make my work section a little bit smaller. I might get a bit better detail. I just don't understand how some of these people that video, I don't know if it's their camera they're using or what, but they can have like big section, but you can clearly see. I really don't know how to do it. So if you guys do know how, please let me know. But till then, I think I'm just gonna make it a bit smaller sections. Like, I don't understand. I'm using the iPhone 13 Pro. I think it's just the know-how. Well, I'm a person that'll admit if I don't know what I'm doing. And right now, I don't know what I'm doing. I know how to do the diamond painting itself, but trying to get the proper viewing angle is the hard part. I will work on it though. Yeah, we're supposed to get 2 to 10 centimeters of snow tonight. We'll see if that actually happens. Not too happy about that because I have to take a half hour drive to go to a doctor's appointment. So that'll be interesting if it snows. Might not too worried, but it'll just take out some extra time to go from work to it, so. Rather arrive safely than wind up in the ditch. Yeah, it kind of sucks. The area that I live in, they just had major flooding happen. town called Abbots or British Columbia that's only about a 15-minute drive from where I am. I'm just, I'm basically in Abbotsford, but I'm so close to the town of Aldergrove, I just call it Aldergrove. But technically, the address that I am at right now is Abbotsford. Just kind of just on the outskirts of Aldergrove. Okay, I just missed 1A. Okay, I need an A. I missed one. I imagine a lot of people do that. You miss one of them, realize there we go. Okay, where am I with K's now? I think I'm around here. There's one. Yeah, it kind of sucks. I was waiting for a nice big mountain scene picture, but pretty sure I'm just going to have to cancel that order. It still hasn't showed up, and it's supposed to have been here on the 30th. I left a message with the seller, basically saying, since I paid for it, either send me a new one or just refund me the money. But I still would have liked to do that one, but like, the thing is, it's saying it shipped. It's through Amazon. But I just don't understand why it's not there. Although I know this is the busiest season for them, so. But when I just checked, today it doesn't even show that it's basically just says shipped. Doesn't show anything else, so I'm like, okay, that's not a good sign, so. I don't know. We'll see what happens to that one. Although I do have, like I said, the AB drills. So all this white is going to be AB drills. I actually have some that I already did. I liked it enough where I'm like, okay, not doing white, just doing, well, I guess still it's white, but it's AB drills. Although these are 5001 AB drills that I have. The ones that are coming are 5200, I think. But I don't really think it's going to matter. As long as it looks sparkly. I just like the look of the AB drills, so. Oops. One thing I don't like about the round drills, hard to keep it straight. I'm not sure how it is with square, But in a couple weeks here, I probably will start one of them that I have. I have two square drill. I believe there's only two there. I think there is, yes. Come on. There we go. So the one company that I have used and actually do like is Everyday E-Deals, I think it's called. Just making sure it's still. Yeah, I believe it's called Everyday E-Deals. Let me see if I can just. Sorry if I'm shaking the camera. Just trying to get more upright. Sorry, I got a drill. I'm just trying to turn over with my drill pin. Okay, I'll just knock you in there then. Okay. Oh, I'm up here. I don't know about any of you guys, but I'm looking forward to Christmas. It's one time of year that I like, other than summer and Christmas time. Those are my favorite times of year. Like I'm kind of run out here. Yep, time to go. Where is cake? That it? Yep. Another thing I like about this bigger tray, you get a lot more. I actually want, like, is it called ripples or whatever they're called? They allow more, like you see here, it's all, I haven't counted, but I could probably do a couple lines of the 15 placer that I have. I got a couple strays over here. Kind of fell out. There we go. Luckily, they're right side up. Okay, where am I here? Just trying to make sure I'm not missing any. So I like to listen to music, obviously when I'm not YouTubing. I mean, I like to listen to music, diamond painting, but not wood and video. That was, yeah, sorry, I kind of messed that up. But you can understand what I meant, I probably. But I do have aftershocks. I could technically listen to music. Although, I have a feeling that because of the music, I might speak a bit louder than I would need to. Which is common at work. Especially when we have earplugs in. I've been diamond painting since March or May, I forget exactly when. Or maybe it's June, somewhere around that time. Don't remember exactly when. But after this one, I do have. Oh, God. How many do I have after this one ready? Or, well, here. I got one, two, I'd say probably six or seven. Then I have four mystery ones coming. And I'm not really sure what's going on with that big one. I have a feeling I'm just gonna get my money back and wait. Unless the seller actually does send one out to me, I would like that, but it's up to the seller. I don't really want the money back. I would actually like to do that one, because that one, I believe it's a picture of Lake Moran, I think it's called. It's a nice big, what size was that one again? I don't remember the centimeter size, but I do remember the inches size. It was 32 inches by 64 inches. Just a massive, nice one though. So, when I got it, it was on sale for $17.25 or something like that, Canadian. Which is the reason why I decided to get it. It's so cheap, I'm like, well, it'd be a no-brainer to get it. That's a four-placer. Oh, there it is. As you see, I do a lot of two-placers with my three-placer. Oops, wrong one. I thought it was at that one there. Oh, that happens quite a bit. Yeah, what got me into diamond painting is when I was a kid, I always liked color by numbers. And when I first saw this, I think it was just an ad on Facebook, actually. I thought, that's kind of interesting. But I didn't really think much about it until my aunt, actually her friend was doing it for a little bit, and I looked more seriously into it, and I'm like, okay, that is something I want to do. So I just started on it. Okay, that's it for this video. Until the next video, please like, comment, subscribe. Thanks, until the next one. Have a good day.